A pleasant good morning to one and all present here. I, Dhvij Patel, would like to speak on the topic, my role model in society. A role model is a person the people look up to in order to determine appropriate behaviors. They motivate us, teach us in a specific way to an extent where we uncover our true potentials and overcome our barriers. As we grow up, we look up to our role models for inspiration. The people who have strong, good role models to follow have a better chance of developing a positive lifestyle. My role model in society is Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google. There are certain qualifications of his that made me look up to him as a role model. He is among the richest CEOs in the world with an average net worth of $650 million. Born in a poor village in Tamil Nadu, he understood the value of success and money more than anything else, which is why he dreamt of achieving great things. Some of you might not consider it as a great talent, but Sundar Pichai remembered each and every telephone number he used to dial in his childhood. He was an engineering genius known for his innovative ideas, best known as the mastermind behind the launch of the Google Chrome in 2008. He played a pivotal role in convincing his seniors at Google to launch a browser, which is now the number one browser in the world, surpassing competitors such as Firefox and Internet Explorer. Today, Chrome is the most popular browser in history. An incredibly humble person at heart, he believes it is always good to work with people who make you feel insecure about yourself. That way, you will constantly keep pushing your limits. An environment replete with formidable characters and much infighting, Pichai emerged as a nice guy who could pull teams together and get work done. He was a person who was happy with his achievements but continued to strive for bigger and better objectives. His most intense passion is the desire to create products that the people could use. He says, as a leader, it's less about trying to be successful and more about trying to make those people successful. Recently, under his leadership, Google has raised $4 million for the refugees all around the world after Trump's ban affects 200 Google employees. While all the employees of Google collectively managed to raise $2 million for the cause, the remaining half was donated by none other than the Indian-born CEO Sundar Pichai himself. Always remember, commitment to a good cause implies a strong commitment to the business. His most highlighting qualities that inspire me are that he is willing to admit his mistakes because he understands the concept that nobody is perfect. He is not just a teacher leading his employees on the road to success, but a constant learner. He has challenged himself out of his comfort zone and surrounded himself with smarter and better people. He may be successful, driven, and smart, but he chooses to show respect and concern to others as well. He does not step on others. Neither does he take others for granted to get ahead. From him, I have learned not to fear from criticism and give my thoughts candidly. And right now, he's inspiring me to speak freely without the fear of failure. There is a great difference between good grades and internal strengths. It is not necessary that in order to become successful in life, you really do need to get good grades. Academics is important, but not as important as it is made out to be. If you follow your heart and do what you like, you will always do much better. It does not matter what your educational qualifications are. We often don't recognize true role models until we notice our own personal growth and progress. That really implies that it takes one to know one. And what is to say that who did not prepare the speeches without taking help from the Google? It is the intricate source of knowledge for everyone. And hence, I conclude by saying, unless you are Google, stop acting like you know everything. Thank you.